Hello everyone, I'm back and here to react to Nostalgia Critic Biodome, one of his old reviews. I've never seen this review, actually. I guess I must have missed it or something. Never had the time or something, just completely forgot about it, but yeah. So, let's see how bad this movie is, because I hear this is really bad. I'm not ready. I'm ready, but I'm not, so let's see how bad this one is. Let's begin.
Hello, I'm the Nostalgia Critic guy, remember? I fucking hate Biodome, I fucking hate Biodome, I fucking hate Biodome, I fucking hate it, I hate it, I hate it, I hate it, I hate it! I hate it! Thanks. Anyway, I fucking hate Biodome. I mean, I don't think I've seen a more annoying and obnoxious piece of cancerous ass. It's so grating and ear-rapingly bad that I'm surprised the movie itself hasn't been arrested for indecent exposure. It may not be the worst movie, but trust me, it's in the top five. This is the movie, these are my wrists after watching the movie, and these are the notes I took during watching the movie. I've never been so happy to get something over with, so let's just go ahead and get this over with. So the film starts appropriately enough by throwing its garbage at us, a fitting metaphor.
This is a man. I have not watched the old Nostalgia Critic in a long time. He's definitely mellowed.
The actor needs to be listed under Pauly Shore. The credits roll on like a cinematic ransom letter until the story finally begins.
The place is the Arizona desert. Here, a team of scientists and investors has come together to create the first space station on Earth. A self-contained world, a pure environment. Their mission will be to sustain life for 1 year while living in harmony with nature.
They're co-naming it the Really Stupid Experiment.
Congratulations, Biodome 5, and good luck.
So while that waste of time is going on, we cut to an even bigger waste of time. This playful scamp is named Squirrel, played by the devil's pubic hair himself, Pauly Shore.
Beg for covers, rock! Chaloose! Creeper!
That was the first line. Literally, the first line he says makes me want to lobotomize myself. We have to watch a whole movie with this anus! Now, for those of you who are young and have no idea who Pauly Shore is, good.
Yeah. Like, you're lucky.
So Shore is joined by his good buddy Stephen Baldwin, who plays another idiot named Doyle. We live in that wonderful time of the 90s where stupid guys didn't really have to have jobs, and yet somehow they live in relatively nice places. Oh, and they also somehow date really hot chicks as well. So Squirrel and Doyle spend most of the time hitting each other with books and explaining why it's smart.
I can't believe you cracked those skulls just to get out of this.
Dad, the book fell on him. I mean, well, he found the book and collided.
Bullshit. But it is just like you two to try and weasel out of your responsibilities on Earth Day.
By the way, yes, that is the lesbian with the funny voice from Chasing Amy. The only thing that gives me hope for all this is that she castrates Pauly Shore and starts making out with the brunette. But I don't think the writers are smart enough to do something so stupid.
Well, they're getting better. Taking yoga, and you're the one that keeps on raving about how flexible Bud is getting.
There is something about a man who can lick his own back.
What am I supposed to say to that? So it turns out these two are super environmental bimbos who want to help clean the environment for Earth Day. But their dumbass boyfriends have even more important things to do. Like, being dumbass boyfriends.
We met these guys from Arizona Tech and are taking us out to this keg at Backstab Break.
I am done. I don't even want to continue this, but I'm going to have to. I don't care about this anymore. This hurts. This is a bad movie. Bad.
They should just retitle this movie Stupid White People Doing Stupider White Things.
Very accurate.
So they get to the spot, only to find out that the ladies tricked them.
They used to be fishy, remember?
Yes, they did, Doyle. A long time ago, when we were kids, right?
Keep going along, Juan.
I'm teaching Bud how to hold his breath underwater.
Much better, Bud. Now let's try for 3 minutes.
Yay! You tried to tell a joke!
You get a vast empty void of silence! So as they start to head back, they come across the biodome, which looks more like bio Pringles cans, as the five scientists get ready to head inside.
Wait, that just started. No, I don't care. I don't care. I don't care. I don't care. Why do I care?
That's not agriculturist. That's Miss October. In fact, only two of these people look like real scientists. The rest look like fashion models. How phony is that? Haven't you seen any movie scientists? They got white lab coats and messed up hair. Like Doc Brown, played by Christopher Lloyd. That was a scientist. These guys are GQ covers. They're insults to movie scientists everywhere. What will Christopher Lloyd say? That's good to know. Thanks, Christopher Lloyd. Oh, by the by, does this head scientist look familiar to you at all?
I'll tell you what's hazardous. You're facing federal
prosecution
for at least a half a dozen environmental
what?
Violations.
That's right. It's
Wait.
Peck from Ghostbusters. And yes, he's an environmental douche in this movie, too.
But one day,
so is this connected? No, I don't care. I don't care. I don't care. This is horrible.
To take a piss while the Nazi from Blues Brothers seals the biodome up with the scientist inside. But wait a minute. Oh, no! They're not supposed to be in there! I smell shenanigans. Or in their case, shit-nanigans.
Get them out now.
The doors are sealed for 1 year. I can't open the doors.
Why?
If I open the doors, the integrity of all the scientific data is compromised.
Just...
Is this true?
Yes, it's true. This man has no dick.
Just start it over. Just start it over from that day. It's a year. It's 1 day.
They can either just open the door up and let them out, simply starting the countdown over again, or they can let these idiotic time bombs stay.
I. God.
Before that, the environmental impact of Bigfoot. So, because face is tight, they had to have them stay in the janitor's closet, where the idea for this movie probably should have stayed.
For the blanket.
For fun. Oh, good. I just heard the soundtrack to my night terrors for the next few weeks.
Thanks.
The squirrel and Doyle find
this is what I get for taking requests.
So it's raping time! So, yeah, the majority of the movie is just these guys acting like douche monkeys as the audience scratches their head trying to figure out what's supposed to be funny about it.
No, God, just...
Has anyone ever noticed that Pauly Shore is to white people what Jar Jar Binks is to black people? I have to say, I'm very offended.
So, hey, I know
Yoga.
Look. Throw it like that.
Hey, that's the best performance of the movie. Finding Pauly Shore funny. That is no easy task.
Hey, wait. Okay, maybe I'll say some other maneuvers later.
Eventually, their girlfriends find out where they are as they go to visit them.
Listen, maybe you're not aware of it, but we're a vital part of the homeo system.
Don't you think your couch is having withdrawals?
Don't you think you should get back to your Jennifer Tilly impersonation?
We gotta go. Bye.
Bye.
Oh, yeah, that's what I'm talking about.
Oh. So close.
So
dag nabbit move, girls. You had it. You're free. You're free. Why? This isn't a movie. I'm not watching this review. I'm just suffering. I'm just suffering. This is all you're getting. Suffering.
To all those really bad YouTube videos you see. You know, the ones where two dickheads do dickheadish things while one dickhead laughs at the other dickhead while that dickhead gets hurt but Sammy's and crippled for life. That's this movie.
Yeah.
God, every new edit of this film hurts me.
Good afternoon, Petri Dish.
Allow me.
Du Pleasant Dick. Chateau Swirly Stub. It's a bit plucky.
So that's what happened to our fruit harvest.
Mini tribal.
Laugh at us! Marco! Chara! Marco! Chara!
Okay,
Why are they not dead? The scientist, I'm shocked they even got this far. What is the social experiment now? Is this turning into
a good idea? Have a point. It makes it so much more interesting for the listener.
Sweet crispy Jesus, every time one of them speaks, I hear a child being murdered. I'm not kidding. That's seriously what I hear every time one of them talks.
Okay, so the scientists
when it comes to their senses and ditch the two bungholes in their indoor desert, leaving them little to no means of survival.
The idea being that while we are here, you are there.
Congratulations, movie. You have me totally siding with the bad guy. Walter Peck in a mullet is the more credible choice here. That's how bad we got.
You can't just leave them there.
Yes, you can! Yes, you can! You can leave them there. They are not helping.
I know this seems incredibly unrealistic as scientists wouldn't usually partake in murder, but I don't care. If it's Pauly Shore and Stephen Baldwin's murder, it's all for the greater good. So they spent several days practically starving to death when they come across an interesting discovery.
A key.
Nugget, you mean this airtight, totally concealed bubble could have been opened this whole time with just a key in the back glass door?
Airtight? How did they get oxygen?
Oh, this plot hole is so bad it's actually physically hurting me. Oh!
I don't care about this plot hole.
So, what do they do?
I don't care. What is happening? I don't care.
A party, of course, as they invite everyone they know back to the biodome so they can have a rockin' good time. The girlfriends hear about it as some sort of Earth Day event where they... Tenacious D?
Go somewhere inside the friggin' trees!
Oh my god, real comedy! Real comedy at last! Oh, save me, Tenacious D! Help me to laugh again!
Just give me something.
Party of Biodome! Alright, let's go!
No! No! Go back to Tenacious D, you ass mongrel! Don't you know real comedy when you see it?
I don't think so. Bruce Lee, maybe next time. Steven Seagal, get in there.
Ah! Funny Dad, welcome to Paris.
We're still not funny.
Dora, look at this place. It's being destroyed.
Don't you guys want to like a big environmental party?
You asshole. But you joined the biodome.
After the party is over and they destroy pretty much everything the biodome was trying to accomplish, they try to put it back together again by restoring all the clean air through just picking up everything. Great, that's like trying to fix Hiroshima by handing out band-aids.
You have any idea how impossible it would be to make this place habitable again?
We're taking over this dome!
We're all gonna die! I am acting! Seriously, this dome
still
couldn't get any less funny if they just shot a clown.
Back and to the left. A clown. Elsewhere, the infamous biodome is back in the news.
My God, you're actually trying to kill comedy, aren't you? You're trying to physically destroy everything that is humorous in this world. You're not going to get away with it. No. How much of this movie is left? 15 minutes?
Oh, thank God. That's enough. That's all I can deal with it.
Walter Peck goes mad and disappears for a while, but returns as the Unabomber. Literally, his hair grows long, he has a beard, and he gets explosives to try to blow off the place. He does this by combining nitroglycerin with coconuts. Just go with it, it'll be over faster. But his plan doesn't work, as the explosions seem to happen next to the coconuts instead of actually hitting them. But he also has a detonator, and plans to use it to blow up the entrance.
Give me the detonator.
What is the magic word? Please.
The bombs blow up, but mysteriously and unfortunately,
for a giant success, and Walter Peck ends the movie by doing his best flying circus impression.
It's...
Monty Python, the flying
circus. Brought to you by the worst of humanity. This is awful! I mean awful! All the funny is replaced by a giant cauldron of annoyance. You just can't comprehend how bad this movie is. It's just two really unfunny people doing really unfunny things and confusing it for something really funny. I haven't been aggravated by a movie like this for a long, long time. And that's saying something considering the movies I've reviewed. Fuck this movie!
Fuck this movie forever!
I'm a nostalgia critic. I remember it so you don't have to!
I do the same thing. Yes, you really do get Christopher's voice to ask for it today.
Bullshit!
Okay, I remember that review. I remember 10 seconds of that review. I couldn't watch it. I couldn't know. No.